Okay, everybody. Hey, Sean here, BW Fusion team. I thought I would do a video now. I've done a lot of the displays. In the next coming days, I'll finish the rest of the displays that would be common to us. We can do any of the older displays or one-offs as we need. But I wanted to do a video that once you've downloaded that data, and you're going to send that over to me to get that into SMS to start processing these trials. You know, so what's that going to look like for you to do, and what is it really going to take to do that? So I wanted to do that. And so what I've got here on my screen is a folder that I just named Stick, and I took all the files that I pulled off of the various displays today as we were doing those exports. And I kind of want to show you what that looks like coming from from those displays. And so right here, this 2106 253J3.CN1. This is the file that would come out of that IntelliVue 4 from a New Holland display or a Pro 700 display. Also, I'm going to do a video on a Pro 600, which there's still a lot of those out there, which is the older case display, and that folder structure will also look the same. If we click inside there, you're going to see log shared. This would say combine instead of sprayer. But basically all the data is contained in these folders, and then you've got this index.vy1. So a mistake that some people make is we'll go back to the root here and look at this. When it comes to the Case IH display, we need every bit of this. So the easiest thing for you to do is on your computer, if you've got that, just click on that folder number, right click on that, and hit send to compressed zip folder. That's going to take a 70 some meg file in this case. You know, some of these larger farms, these could be in the hundreds of megs, and that's why we can't email them. We're not going to be able to email a lot of this data because it's just too large. So we're going to work out a system there. I will send you most likely a link to, I use OneDrive a lot. So I may send you a link to a OneDrive folder that I create just for BW yield data. You guys will be able to upload things there. And just by zipping these, we'll make sure that we get all the contents of the folder. It makes these much smaller. And then we'll have something that is much easier to work with. And so instead of this being, you know, same folder, 76.6 megs, you know, now that is a 21 meg folder. Something that we can easily upload and get that over. The next one I'm going to look at here is the second one, this 242001146 planner. All right, so basically this is what's going to look like coming out of that ag leader in command, either the 1200 or the 800 or an Integra or Versa. And what's going to be interesting is this is basically going to be whatever the grower or the grower's dealer, when they set up that display, it's going to be whatever they named it. And the first numbers are the serial number of that display. So if you do a bunch of these things, the way you're going to know that this is ag leader data is if you open that up and you're going to see the dot ag data at the end. That file extension lets us know that that is ag leader data. This one was saying that, you know, this was pulled 7 of 2017. So this is some older data that I used just to do the demonstration. But again, in this case, it's these files are so much simpler with the ag leader side because you may have a bunch of these, and depending on how the growers got the export set up, if it may drop folders of the grower's name and different entities and things like that. But when we see these again, on all these, realistically, if you just want to right click on these and hit send to compressed zip folder, it's going to take care of a lot of us. The ones, let's see, what else might be different? So that takes care of the ag leaders. Send to 2020. This is what's going to look like coming out of the Gen 3 displays. So it seems counterintuitive to call it send to 2020, but that's what it is. We open that up. We see we only exported the one grower farm and field. And so we have the one folder, it's JRT Farms. That's the farm and then the airport and year 2021, airport 130 is the field name. And the 2020 file that we see here is the file that we, you know, that we're going to be working with. One thing that's kind of nice about a 2020, we talked about how you can pull out a single field or you can transfer all of them. If you transfer all of them, you've got a folder here that's going to be every grower, farm, and field set up. So you'd have a whole list here of folders, and that would be every individual farm. Okay. So in this case, I don't necessarily have to have the Send to 2020 folder. I don't necessarily have to have that. But still, just for simplicity's sake, just take that Send to 2020 and then Send to Compress Zip folder. That'll take care of that one as it's compressing and zipping that. The older style, the Gen 2 that we talked about, that data is going to come out looking like this. It's going to have the grower name, it's going to have the farm name, and it's going to have the monitor serial number on it. So that's what we look at here. That's what this number is Louis Bernard, Amanda Benson is the farm and the monitor serial number. So similar to what's inside the Send to 2020 folder from the Gen 3. And again, it's the same way. The only difference here is instead of having this root folder, this Send to 2020, if you transfer all, you're going to see every one of the growers and the farms just listed right there on the stick. So you'd have to manage those individually by basically zipping all of those individually and sending them over. But again, just right click Send to Compress Zip folder. The John Deere stuff, you know, that John Deere is going to come out if it's a, and I haven't done a video on the GS3, the 2630 or 2600 just yet. But what you'll see here, if it comes out of a 2630 or a Gen 4, it's going to have a file structure of GS3_2630. Inside that, you will see like JD4600. This is the 4640 display that we played with. Inside that, you're going to have an RCD folder. Inside that, you're going to have the EIC folder. And inside that, you're going to have all of this global spatial catalog, the host, the setup. We need every bit of this. Matter of fact, I even need this all the way back to the 2630, the GS3_2630. On the GS3, it'll ask you if you want to name your profile, which is really neat when they come out. So you, like, I name them, like, for you guys, if it comes to this, name it like 2021 Mr. Farmer. That way we know whose data is coming in, and you could see a whole list of those if you went around to see four or five guys, you know, that had John Deere combines and you exported that data. It's all going to go in that one GS3_26 folder, 2630 folder, but then you would see subfolders here like this 2021 Harvest 1, the John Deere 4600. They would just all be listed here. And so if you wanted to send all those at once, you just zip that GS3_2630 folder, and we are good to go there. I may update this as we get a little bit more, but realistically, we've talked about the precision planting monitors and how to zip that up. We've talked about the John Deere monitors and how to zip that up, and they will all come the same. The only difference is the old GS2 that takes the data card that going to be named GS3_2600. Otherwise, everything's the same there. The Ag Leaders and the Case and the New Holland. So basically, if we just get that data, if we zip it up, and I'll send a link a little bit later to a OneDrive where you guys can drop that data and we will get that process. So that being said, thanks, guys. Obviously, if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me at any time and I can walk you through most of these just from memory, and we can get you set up and get that data in. So thanks, guys.